Hi guys, hope you are doing well from wherever you're watching me, depending on your time zone. Now, on September 6, 2021, the Deputy President William Samoei Ruto communicated to his followers through Dennis Itumbi, a man who is part of his communication team, asking them to protest against watching Citizen TV because of inaccurate and malicious reporting on his campaign events. So during that time, the Deputy President had an event in Kieni constituency, which is in Nyeri County. So Citizen TV were running a headline on their bulletin that mob storm Deputy President William Samoei Ruto motorcade in Noru, church declined to host DP Ruto in his Nyeri visit. That was the headline there. So I think the team was not happy to see how Citizen TV was reporting. But again, this was true. The road were barricaded. We have some youth who were shouting to Ruto. But at the end of the day, still he managed to have the event. So Itumbi, on his platform, is referring to as the Hustler Nation Intelligence Bureau. He went ahead to write a statement which was broadly shared out with the Hustler Nation bloggers, asking these people to stop watching Citizen TV. And by the way, before I forget, you might be watching me and you have not yet subscribed. Please subscribe so that any other time you will never miss our video. And all the 10 subscribers, thank you so much for always staying around. Let us give this video thumbs up and let us share the video out where necessary. So up to now, we understand that the Hustler Nation are no longer watching Citizen TV. So what caught my eye attention is the statement that Dennis Itumbi is posting out yesterday. And I'm still laughing about this statement. So this is what he wrote. 9:37 p.m. That's 7 minutes into news. No story on DP William Samoei Ruto. He goes on to say, the editors manning the running order at Citizen TV Kenya decided William Samoei Ruto and the Hustler Nation belongs to the filler, part of the bulletin. He continues to say, his official Citizen TV is Fox News of 2022 campaign slander for Raila Amolo Odinga. Nisawa. We were here in 2013, even forget Uhuru Ruto. Robinson Githae was vying for governor in Kirinyaga. He got preference treatment, but the people made their decision on ballot. So this is not a complaint. It is just a note that Citizen TV has picked its side, and that is okay. We will go direct to the people to tapatana, to patane mbele. So that is a statement from Dennis Itumbi, speaking on behalf of William Samoei Ruto. So I'm so much surprised to read such a statement from Dennis Itumbi, keeping it in mind that sometimes back, 1 month, Dennis Itumbi issued a statement asking every person who support William Samoei Ruto and anyone who believe in the Hustler Nation, anyone who believe in bottom-up approach to the economy model, should go ahead and resist from watching Citizen TV, because for them they believe that Citizen TV was inaccurate in their reporting towards the event that William Samoei Ruto was involving himself. So my question number one is, if the Hustler Nation guys believe that Citizen TV number one is inaccurate in their reporting towards them, again, number two, they believe that they are reporting malicious statement about William Samoei Ruto. So how does the same team still demand or complain about Citizen TV not reporting about the event that William Samoei Ruto has been involved himself? Remember, William Ruto is in Mombasa, Akouko, for almost, is it 3 days tour? So he's engaging the peoples of coastal region. And for that reason, Dennis Itumbi anticipated that Citizen TV should have given a privilege to William Samoei Ruto. Sasa swali ni kwamba, if this team believe that Citizen TV is not credible, and at the same time they are asking the same station or complaining about the same station not reporting William Samoei Ruto event. So who is cheating who? Who is fake among these guys? Who is reporting fake information between the Hustler Nation and the Citizen TV? It tells you openly that these guys did not really have a serious complaint about Citizen TV. If their complaint was valid and serious, then I don't see the reason why they should continue complaining about Citizen TV not giving a wide coverage about the event that William Samoei Ruto is involving himself. So in my view, Itumbi could simply be telling us that the protest that they called for against Citizen TV was not taken seriously by all the followers of the Deputy President William Samoei Ruto and anyone who believe maybe in hustler thing or the bottom-up economy. It means these people heard what he said, but they refused to listen, to follow the order he gave to them. Or is he telling us that these guys did not hear what he said? So in my conclusion, I believe, and even in one of the video, I did a video, by the way, about this issue on September 9th. I'm going to put a link here. And this is what I said, that as of now, the only person that many Kenyans, and I myself believe that if we call for protest, there will be an impact and people might take the direction that is giving to them, is one and only Raila Amolo Odinga. Lakini hawa wengine wote, I don't see a serious person who can come, call for a protest, then at the end of the day, we see a real protest and we see an impact to that. Remember, during 2017 general election, when Raila said, resist Brookside, when Raila said, resist Safaricom, the giant business in Kenya, what happened? Safaricom was simply going down. Everyone was embracing Airtel, and even Airtel started booming during that time. The SIM card were being sold so largely, and people were now embracing Airtel. So Airtel was making business by that time, while Safaricom even reported that definitely they have had an impact since the time Raila called for a resist. So it tells you, Raila, with his followers, when he give a direction, people might listen to him. So I'm concluding that if Ruto can give a direction to the people who he believe are his followers, they might not go ahead to listen to his statement. So my question is, what if Ruto become the next opposition leader? Will he really be a serious opposition leader whom when he speak, people will listen to him? Or when he call for a protest against the mistreatment from government, people might listen to him and take that direction? Because Raila has proved to be one. When anything goes wrong in the country, call for a protest, people will come out. But I'm attempting to believe that William Samoei Ruto might not be even a strong opposition leader, just in case he gets to be in opposition side or the minority side of the government. So number three, Itumbi has confirmed to public that Citizen TV has a preferred candidate and is none other than Raila Amolo Odinga. And one thing that this team is forgetting is the statement that William Samoei Ruto normally issued when some of these owners of the media companies are having their meeting. For example, the Mount Kenya Foundation meeting, where SK Macharia was part of that team. Ruto anaita hawa jamaa dynasties, mabwenyenye, people sitting somewhere trying to decide for the country. So all the kind of abuses he gave to them. My question is, how do you dare come then at the same time and expect the same team to give a preference to you, to sell your agenda to the public, you know, using their media company? How can it work? So in one way, William Samoei Ruto did not understand how he should have gone through this issue, because even at the same time, he still needs these guys to do a coverage for him. So for them, Citizen TV has decided, maybe in one way, they'll be just doing just a short coverage of what William Samoei Ruto is trying to do, just to make sure they're trying to balance this issue out. But in real sense, you'll find that the person that they are seriously selling out is one Raila Amolo Odinga. By the way, even in 2017, Citizen TV was with Raila Amolo Odinga when the other media companies were sidelining with William Samoei Ruto and President Uhuru Kenyatta. But the biggest problem William Samoei Ruto will have in 2022, look here. Citizen TV, iko na Raila. We are talking about KTN News, Gideon Moi. Is he a supporter of William Samoei Ruto? No. We are talking about K24. It is believed to be part of the Kenyatta family. Uhuru Kenyatta akona nani? Raila Amolo Odinga. So, what is William Samoei Ruto left with the outside there? Because the mainstream media here, zile ziko strong, is Citizen, KTN, na hiyo K24. Then NTV nafuatilia. NTV sasa hata imerudi huko nyuma. So, these three major ones, none of them is with William Samoei Ruto. So, Ruto need to work extra hard. It's like hakujipanga vizuri na mambo ya communication. Yet, at the same time, he still want to fight this same guy. Now, thank you so much for listening to me up to this far. Let us meet in the comment section. And if you have not yet subscribed, please just subscribe so that any other time, you always get our video timely.